First of all, liposuction or laser liposuction are invasive. They're minimally invasive. They're just going below the skin, but you have to cut the skin and get inside the skin to do the procedure. So basically, you're putting a cannula in, a suction cannula in, to mechanically disrupt the fat cells and suck them out or melt them out with a laser device. You're going to have to use some sort of local anesthesia, or some people will even do general anesthesia for liposuction. With the non-invasive devices, of course, you don't have to use any sort of general anesthesia ever, or typically no local anesthesia, and of course no incisions. With liposuction, you also are mechanically destroying the fibrous bonds, the fibrous tissue that holds the skin to the fat, to the muscle, to the connective tissue. And those have to regrow and reapproximate the skin to the connective tissue after the procedure is over. So that's what the compression garments are usually used for after a liposuction or a laser liposuction. Those garments need to be worn for at least a couple weeks, sometimes even a couple months after the procedure. They're not required after a non-invasive device or procedure like CoolSculpting or Liposonics. The other difference is risk. There's a little bit more risk involved with obviously an invasive procedure than a non-invasive procedure. Liposuction is going to involve risk due to the amount of local anesthesia that's used. Your liver has to process all of that lidocaine. If it's awake tumescent liposuction, your liver has to process all of the lidocaine from the liposuction. And obviously, if it's general anesthesia, that has some of the heaviest risk involved. I think the skin is the biggest difference between the two procedures. Afterwards, with a liposuction or a laser lipo, the skin can be left very lumpy and bumpy and sometimes saggy and baggy. With the liposonics or CoolSculpting, the skin is left perfectly intact and smooth and unchanged, or sometimes even improved. You're not going to have any visible incisions like you will with a laser lipo or a liposuction procedure. The amount of fat between liposuction and laser liposuction and the non-invasive procedures can be very, very different. That's one of the biggest dissimilarities. Because of the liposuction, you're typically taking out 70% of the fat in that area at one time. So you're taking out a lot more fat than you will with non-invasive procedures like CoolSculpting or Liposonics. Sometimes those non-invasive devices will require one to as many as three treatments.